Hey everyone, Rodney here from Cleves Tech. Can you get Midjourney-like results with Stable Diffusion? Can you get those results with just four steps? Today I'm going to give you a quick rundown on a LoRA I ran into the other day, Midjourney Mimic, which is created to give you Midjourney 5.2 model-like results using Stable Diffusion. Now I'm a big user of Midjourney myself for some things, so I decided to give this a try and see if it does what it says. Now since Fooocus is my primary Stable Diffusion tool, I did my experimenting with Fooocus. Unless I mention otherwise, all these images were generated using only the Fooocus V2 prompt expansion, and I went with the first generated image, so there was no cherry picking of good images. I used the same seed. Did the same thing with the checkpoint. I used the Juggernaut XL version 8. This LoRA is designed to mimic Midjourney style 5.2, and it works, they say, as a detail tweaker, which supplements the picture with details, color enhancer, adds contrast, brightness, background depth enhancer, which adds depth onto the background. They do recommend it use only with weight from 0.1 to 0.8. You can set more, but the picture, they said, will be colored, smooth edges, can break proportions. In my experimentations, yeah, definitely anything over 8 weren't the greatest results. Now, I will include a link to this, obviously, in the description. And if you're not familiar with how to get and add models to Fooocus, I do have a video that covers that for detailed instructions. But basically, as with all of these, you're going to download, you put it into whatever folder. The default one for Fooocus is in the Fooocus models folder, and then there's a LoRA folder, and that's all you do. You put it in there. And to download it from this site, if you go from here, is just go over to download options, you click there, and then you click on the file here, and then choose where you want to save it. Save it to whichever folder you keep your LoRAs in. Now, if you have it running, and you download it, you do need to click on the refresh all files so it will see the new ones, and then you just select it in the drop down. And as we can see here, I have it selected, and then you want to adjust the weight. 0.1 to 0.8 is the recommended. That's pretty much what I found. I actually even found a lot over 0.5 or 6, really. Most of the time I didn't like the results, but it depended on the image. So I'm not going to make you wait around for the lightning results if you're curious about that, because I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on those because I don't use the lightning model a lot. I'm still experimenting a lot with it. So I had it set up to use the lightning setting in Fooocus. And in there, I was using the Fooocus V2 style, and the model was the Juggernaut. And I did it with the Midjourney LoRA off and with 0.5 settings. And the results of that, the top two images are the default lightning without the LoRA enabled, and the bottom two are with it set at 0.5. Depending on what you're going for an image, I do like the bottom images better. That's basically the lightning results. So it does, to me, it seems to approve it when I played around with it. Now let's just look at the regular results. The first image on the top left would be LoRA disabled, and then we had it at 0.25, 0.5, and 0.75. Probably at the lower weights, I find it's more close to the 5.2. In certain aspects, it does change it, is all I can really say there. Like for this image, I prefer the one without it disabled, maybe at 0.25, but. And so the Magical Forest, I would like the bottom two images preferably, but then again, it depends on what you're really going for the look. Now for our wizard, definitely liked it around the 0.5 weight. I thought that was the best image overall. And for the woman dancing in the street, thought the bottom two were better. It definitely improved. I felt that the standard one just wasn't that great. As for the tranquil forest at sunrise, I think the last one with the heavier weight actually came out best. But then again, I like all of them. I don't know if they hit it perfectly with everything here. I like the results of this LoRA overall. Now for our still life, 0.5 is the one I like the most. As for the astronaut one, I think the original one was probably fine. There, none of them are perfect. I'd say most of these are pretty bad images. Bottom left got some really bad stuff going on. So we'll just move on to the next one. Sailing ship, Viking sailing ship. I like the bottom, I think 0.5. I don't know, it might could be that lightning is making it much better. Then we have our hobbit hole. Now the original one looks like I went outside and took a picture of it. My opinion. The other ones are, yeah, definitely I can see the Midjourney influence through these. And on this one, I think as well, it's holding the coffee cup properly for the most part. They're not too out of whack. I usually don't get those good of results. And just to give a comparison of what I got for when I went from the lightning settings I showed before back over to the standard, just the juggernaut under the quality settings, just so I'd have a comparison. So these were the lightning ones that you're seeing on the screen right now. But these are a couple examples. These are the same prompt run under the standard quality settings juggernaut. The one on the left is the default juggernaut settings. And the one on the right is with the 0.5 on the Midjourney. So here's another one. Same prompt. Midjourney is on the right with that at 0.5. On the left is just the standard juggernaut. I can definitely see the Midjourney type influence on this. That should give you an idea if you want to check that LoRA out, especially if you're, you know, a big fan of Midjourney or you just want to get similar results, whatever it may be. So it does have overwhelmingly positive ratings on the civitai.com website, and a lot of the reviews are really good. So go check that LoRA out, download it, and play around with it. Thanks for watching the video. And if you found it helpful, please do hit the like button. Any tips for getting better results with this LoRA, just drop it in the comments for everyone. Any other suggestions for any good LoRAs, definitely put them in the comments. I do plan on doing some more videos like this and hope you have a good time creating.